And say my acquaintance from Delhi, Mr. Prabhu Chawla, alumni in his own right, a face which is seen almost daily on the national media, hardly needs any introduction. But as the courtesy demands, I would just like to take a minute to introduce Mr. Prabhu Chawla, who is editorial director of New Indian Express Groups and is a host of new talk show Sachi Baat on the Indian News Hindi channel. Mr. Chawla did his education in Delhi and studied economics at Delhi School of Economics. He started his career as a lecturer in economics in Delhi University. One of the India's finest political journalists, Mr. Chawla is known for his sharp political analysis and investigative reports. In his 40 years as reporter and editor, he has written extensively on events that changed the political course of India and people who engineered those. Prior to his assignment with the Indian Express, he was the editor of language publications in the India Today News magazine. He is credited with launching the regional editions of the India Today magazines in Hindi, Tamil, Telugu and Malayalam. Before holding this post, he worked as an editorial director of the magazines for 24 years until 2010. He has hosted a weekly talk show, Sidhi Baat, on Aaj Tak, India's most popular television show, where he greeted prominent personalities. He was awarded Padma Bhushan by the President of India in 2003. He has also won several national awards, including the Hero Wanda Indian Television Academy Best Anchor Award for Sidhi Baat, TV News Anchor of the Year Tele Awards in 2003, TSR Kalapithan Lifetime Achievement Award in 1998, GK Reddy Memorial Awards for Investigative Reporting, Current Affairs in 1989, and the list goes on and on. Today, he is one of the most authoritative and credible voices in print as well as in visual media. Ladies and gentlemen, I introduce to you the chief guest of the today, Mr. Prabhu Chawla.
Good evening, Goa. Instead of saying President, Vice President, and Member of the Jury and everybody else, I'm saying good evening to everybody who has come here to listen to me. And I must thank Goa Chambers of Commerce and Industry for thanking me and giving me an opportunity to speak to Goans. I don't speak the local language, because some of you spoke in local language as well. He has given an introduction about how many awards I get. And today's function is also regarding awards. Before I came here, I was discussing with my friend Mangesh. What should I say? Any indication of any idea? Because I don't know how many speeches. What should I speak on about our profession? These days is not a what you call flavor of the month. Because media, if you talk about media today, everybody looks at it as something we have come from third world, or we are some criminals roaming around as journalists and whatnot. Well, one of the award winners pointed out that media space is shrinking from professional journalism. Somebody else spoke about one of the editors who gave a very good speech and made so many points about freedom of expression and how he found so many mistakes, quality of journalism is going down. These are the issues which are obviously bothering everybody else. But the basic question I was asking, what should I speak about it? Responsibility of a journalist? Because what is happening in this country now? What is wrong with the society because of us? When we do something, we are not appreciated. When we we attack somebody, we are not appreciated. But if something is wrong, if somebody is criminal, somebody is looting the country, somebody is corrupt, aap kya kar rahe hain? आपने क्या किया? Why media is silent? Now the new word has come, paid media. We are always paid, why? We get salary for writing. We are not professional worker, working in some kind of a, we are on a mercy petition like everything. And media is not a social organization. We must not live under the impression that media is not, if media is a no profit, no loss making kind of organization. It's a business proposition. thing is, it is not working for valuation in fee, like Chamber of Commerce or anything. What is the valuation of a particular company? They look for market expansion, they look for eyeballs, they look for something else. And therefore, valuation of the company should must go up. So when we are known as paid media, that's the thing which bothers me now. Because if we write something, we are damned. If we don't write, we are damned. So we are in a position where we don't know what to do about it. You elected Lalu Prasad Yadav, why are you blaming me? If you have elected Siddaramaiah, why are you blaming me? If you have elected Manmohan Singh as the Prime Minister, never spoke for 5 years, why are you blaming me? And if I have gone and voted on behalf of you, 50 crore votes were voted for the Congress party, what were you doing? Why are you not attacking him? Even after attacking, you elect the same government. 67% of the MPs and MLAs in this country are corrupt criminals. Who have elected them? If you look at the media coverage of these politicians, all of us have been writing about them, reams after reams, words after words, but after end of it, what happened? They all win. So where does media role? You have some kind of an inflated imaginary image about our media, that we can change the world. Modi has been elected not because of us, but in spite of us. For 12 years, media, English media of this country was after him like that you throw him into somewhere in the sea in Goa. But he got elected. He changed the history of the world. He's the first leader who addressed the maximum number of meetings. He's the first leader who addressed the maximum number of crowds in less than 90 days. The entire media was after him, calling him all sorts of names. But we were Hindi media, English media, everything, which was non-voters of Modi, means they were not the voters in Gujarat, they were all attacking him. Because it doesn't go from their pocket anything, because they are not going to vote for him at that point in time. So what is the role of media? What are we expected to do? I have been in journalism for the last 35 years. I don't know what changes have gone into this industry. The people are now expecting us to change the government, make the government, kill the leader, make them, unmake them, make them, demake them. I don't know what should we do. I'm really amazed. We get an award for what? Another question. I got so many awards. I'm counting them now. It is a good thing to be recognized for your work. But Goa Chamber of Commerce and Industry recognize some journalists, some question can be asked. Why an industrial chamber of commerce is recognizing journalists? For what? If somebody else give me Padma Bhushan, then government give me what? For what? But some question can be asked. Somebody can say, I am opposed to BJP. Somebody can say, no, I am anti-Sonia. You go on the Twitter, for example. What is happening? Media is becoming totally irrelevant now. Because there are so many options you have got. You got 250 news channels in the country. India is the only country where you open the TV in the evening in the bedroom, you have the what you call the remote control. Now journalists are not only controlled by the owners, they are remote controlled by you also. You are our remote control. If you don't like my face, Prabhu Jawal is coming, he is speaking bunkum, he is not supporting Modi, then switch it off. I will not see. So this is what is happening. You are deciding the fate of journalism every second. TRP has become something which everybody is bothered about. If your show is seen by millions of people because TRP, you shout more, you get more viewers. That is what is happening this time. Shouting, acting, dressing, how you look on the TV, that gets you more TRP rather than what contents you speak. Other thing which is bothering me now, earlier in 90s, 70s, 80s, when we joined journalism, there were few editors, a couple of editors, who were also owners. Which is a trend which nobody has noticed. So why we have a question? I was thinking of what is, I am in the sunset stage now. I am 68 year old. I don't own any media. Question is, in 90s, 70s, 80s, there were few people who were editors, also owners. But they were not in the industry. Whether it was Telegraph, whether it was Times of India, whether it was Indian Express. Important paper like Malayalam Manorama, like the Kendaran. These were papers owned by the owners, they were editors, but they were not industrialists. Their only source of income was newspaper industry, but they are not treating as a newspaper industry. Now what has happened? Post-reform, with all the reform area, Manmohan Singh reform, you are my teacher by the way, and don't blame him what I am today, all the good work I have done. Because what he taught us at that time, he became exactly the opposite. He was totally communist now, in Marketeer, of the best order. So I'm telling you that after the reforms, what has happened? Media has been opened up. Narasimha Rao, when he became 91 Prime Minister of India, I was the first female journalist, I was the editor of Indirect Press at that time, undivided Indirect Press. I did the first interview. He asked me, Ek Baat Batao Prabhu, how did Star TV come into India? That was only immediate. I said, Upar Se Uth Ke Aa Gaya. I'm telling you, this is the Prime Minister of India doesn't know how Star News came into India. And since then, how many channels have come, internet come, everything has come. It's a media expansion has come because government doesn't know how to handle it. 252 news channels, total number of licenses given so far is about 800 news channels. We are becoming increasingly irrelevant. Somebody said about it on the front page, it is being sold. When I'm talking about the basic thing, why is it happening? Because earlier there were few editors who were owners. Now there are many editors who are owners. They have joined the club of owners of the newspapers. So then if your editor is editor, I am a professional editor, I am not an owner editor. If I try to become an owner editor, then my whole outlook about media changes. Why I have become owner? Because I want the valuation of my share to go up. But the question which I have been raising, the time has come for all of us now. That all editors must declare their assets in public. Number two, all those editors who are shareholders in the company must declare how many shares they have got at what price. Number three, if they have sold shares, at what price have they sold and to whom they have sold. So now newspapers are listed companies. You can find out. Because if I buy what you call stocks in the company, the options are given to us, if I get stock options, then I get a 10 rupees, 20 rupees or whatever that is happening. And I sell it to later on, 2 years later, 3 years later, at 1,000 rupees without paying a tax because there is no tax on it. There is no dividend tax, there is tax on the long term capital gains. That's another thing that has happened there. So ideas of information gathering has become little more easy now because everybody is coming to you with their handout. Earlier, we used to go to chaprasis, deputy secretaries, under secretaries, your Congress president, BJP vice president, local president. But now they all come to you through internet. They will Twitter to you, and you pick up a story on Twitter itself. Why do you go there? So we are not getting primary information. Our sources are secondary now. Twitter, Facebook, they have become the sources of information for newspaper and TV channels. Look at TV channels. They are now showing Twitter also. When they are doing the program, then they are saying Twitter. So and so it said this, so and so this, said this, so and this. And they pick up news from Twitter. Modi ji ne Twitter pe kya kaha, then that becomes the lead story. And Modi knows this is the only way of teaching lesson to the media. I will not beat you to look at my Twitter and to make up this. The problem with us is inaccessibility because of our own conduct. Should we get the information, the truth, which is first hand, what I have heard, what I have seen, or what I have heard from somewhere else, ki usne kaha to maine suna, usse dekha to mere bataya, wo story ban gayi. That has to be totally over. Somebody in the beginning said, Lokmanya. If a document comes with it, it should be accepted to all. This is the right place. You had a death anniversary yesterday celebrated here. Media should be Lokmanya. It is not happening. It is not mandated to do itself. Ab inke log iski baat nahi mante, baaki log kaise manenge? Media is being isolated now. Comparison between what they call politician and press is almost similar. We are keeping it in the same category. The trend has become, but I am still proud of that India is the only country where the press is still most independent than the Western press. They are teaching us lesson. New York Times wrote an editorial 3 days ago. They are condemning about the ownership of Indian media. That how Indian media is losing control to the corporate like Reliance took over IBM and somebody else took over India Today, somebody else is talking about this. They wrote an editorial. What is happening in New York? New York Times, everybody knows who owns. They're teaching us the lessons. How they cover up various scandals in their own country when all the banks collapsed in New York. Is any newspaper there who has written? Who looted the American banks? Has anybody has gone to jail there? Has any newspaper exposed that? All the CEOs of the bank, which were closed after 150 years, all the CEOs are not living on the sea beaches with yachts and planes and whatnot. That is what American newspapers are doing. They're teaching us lessons of freedom in press. We are still the best. But the question marks are being raised. That bothers me now. What else bothers me? Somebody says he's looking at the full stop, he's looking at the punctuation, looking at the grammar. That is not what people are looking at, because most of the people don't know English properly. Indian writes better English than the Englishman, that's correct. But the question is, they want to know the content. What is the color of the content? What is the grammar of the content? What is the tapestry of the content? They want news now. They don't want views. What is happening that we are trying to give them views? Look at the Chini channel. Every panelist is fighting with each other. One of the anchor doesn't allow anybody else to speak. So when we are getting the viewers supposed to, as an anchor, which I was not when I joined, I did my show, Sikhidibar. I never did TV show before that. Arun Puri was the boss who taught me how to do journalism. He said, "Nahi, Prabhu, tum karo." I can't do it. He said, "No, you do it." We call it Sikhidibar. No rehearsal, no dummy show. I sat in front of the camera. My guest, first guest was the then finance minister, Jaswant Sinha. And I asked him questions. So out of the 20-minute show, it was given to me that you will not speak more than 7 minutes. 1/3 of the time is given to you, 2/3 goes to the guest. I never exceeded that limit today. Because I am here to extract news out to the guest. Not tell the guest what you should be doing. मैं तुम्हारे को पढ़ाने के लिए नहीं आया भाई. My viewer wants that. How this man, what is khabar he is going to give? But what is happening? I'll give you another example of it. And what happened in this 26/11? I was in Bombay, staying in a different Taj hotel. I was supposed to stay in the same Taj hotel, but I stayed in the west in the far away. And luckily for me, I didn't stay there because they had an appointment in that side. That massacre took place, bomb blast started ticking, those people started blowing the hotel up. I went there at 10 o'clock. And so I was perhaps the youngest, in the sense I'm joking, sarcasm. I was the youngest person there who was reporting live. I was 63 years, others were 23, 24, 25, 28. So I was asked to live by my anchor sitting in Delhi at 1 o'clock in the night. They were all trying, they were doing more acting. How do you compete with these girls and boys? Luckily, I had an experience, I knew some police officers. So my job was to gain information, their job was to sensationalize it. I was getting information from police officers who were, they respected me because I was old and I was an editor of a magazine also. So information gathering has become now only some kind of an exception. News gathering is becoming an exception. News gathering is becoming a fashion. Point. I remember one of the home ministers, I'm not going to name a journalist. TV journalist, young, bright girl, came to interview him. She interviewed him for 20 minutes, and after the interview, I was standing there. She asked him, "Which party do you belong to, sir?" But this is the level of journalism which has, because expansion of media which has happened in such a way that we can't get good, talented people. Getting a good sub-editor in this country is like finding a diamond in a red desert. You can't find sub-editor who can write the right English. You can't find a reporter who knows that even the home minister of his own state, or a good author, or a good musician, they don't know anything about it. And Wikipedia has become the curse of our generation. Wikipedia, everything is wrong. And I see many stories which I catch when the photos write, because they lift from Wikipedia or somewhere else and just write the story and it goes. And he says, I don't want to read the paper which I have written. That's true of many editors. They don't want to read what is being written by the correspondent. I'm getting messages right now. Have you read the story? It is a front page story. I said, I don't want to read it. Print it. I read it in the morning and give you all the whatever passion I have to give. Problem with the media at the moment, it challenge before us is that we should go back to the old system of raising what I call W's, five W's principle. Why, what, where, and what next? That question is forgotten. We don't ask why. We just take the handout and abide and go. Somebody says where, what, and why, we don't answer. If somebody is speaking Natarajan yesterday, day before yesterday, I was the person who wrote the cover story along with my other colleague. We tapped his secretary, by the editor of India Today, Maharani. He knew me very well. He told my correspondent who was covering foreign affairs that I will speak to Prabhu only. I said, let him speak. Well, I wanted to get the truth out of it. He started speaking to me. I just went on nudging. I said, yes, such bata do kushya. He said, thode din the phone. By that time, I knew he would call me back. I put tape recorder on the phone. He didn't know I was taping. I tapped the whole conversation, made an interview as a cover story of India Today. And Natarajan had to go after that. It was only an interview given by a secretary which made a cover story of India Today and headline today. And same headline today had done the interview now in Natarajan. But forgot to ask the question that why was you sacked? Your own channel got in sacked. Your own magazine got in sacked. Your book doesn't talk about the incident. Volcker Commission report for which you are sacked, it is not in the book. You are saying Sonia Gandhi, who made you what you are today, otherwise you would have been retired Babu, somewhere retiring, somewhere sitting in the Rajasthan village where he belongs to. I know for 30 years. I'm talking about journalism now. Natarajan in one example where nobody is asking, not after the fifth day has done the interview, now people are asking it, Volcker Commission, even Congress party ka naam bhi tha. They ask me to interview him. I said, I'll interview me. But he doesn't, when you are writing out the book in which you are blaming Sonia Gandhi of many things, and if you read his statement when he gave it to us at that time, Sonia Gandhi is God for me. Durga Mata has, when she didn't become the Prime Minister, what a sacrifice she has done. Now she has, his son told me. In India Press, there is an interview. That what a sacrifice Sonia Gandhi has done, which no woman in the world has done, no leader in the world has done, that is the interview published in India Today. Now he says, what a dictator then? But one must question as a journalist why he is saying that. Is he Modi, 83 years old, whether he wants to become a governor? What he says, some of the things are correct there. But they are not unknown. But as a journalist, my job is to find out what he is saying, why he is saying, what is the time. All of you are interested in that. But it becomes sensational news. We are used to giving half-baked, half-information because we are in a hurry to come out with the news first. That's a competitive journalism is a threat to independence of journalism. That's the basic problem. Conviction of profession is becoming matter of convenience now. But the convenience for me, I have to give a bite immediately. Kya hoga? I never think something. When I type kya hoga, straight on the air. Without checking. Next time, it's incorrect. Somebody told me, okay, TV journalism has only one advantage, that if you are wrong, you can correct it in the next minute. But that doesn't mean you have to go and tell the lies to the country. That freedom nobody has given you. So when I'm saying why, what and where and what next, that are the golden principles of journalism which we are avoiding these days. A, because we editors don't find enough talented people in this. Because there are so many channels, there are so many newspapers, there are so many magazines, there are no properly trained manpower or input or human material which we can use to give some kind of independent journalism which you want. We can't do it because we don't have people. And other thing is because media is getting into listed now companies. There are some pressure coming from outside. But overall, all newspaper owners, all TV channel owners, they want their product to be sold. If the credibility of a newspaper goes down, he will lose. Channel will be closed down. Newspaper will lose circulation. The every industry may be wanted to influence, peddle influence, use the newspaper for personal benefit. But the end of it, if newspaper and channel doesn't survive, he will also go down with it. So that's the weakness that editors must exploit to bring back some kind of a bite in journalism, which we are looking. So that's a challenge before us. Technology, I'm not going to talk about it, because our competition is from the social media itself. Social media is so active, and it is very politicized. It is very classified. Classified in the sense they belong to classes. Social media divides people according to classes and pedigree. You look at Twitter, look at the followers, they follow each other. You'll find some people coming from the special college or institution or party, they follow each other. They don't follow people who have not gone to good college like St. Chikung, St. Navy or whatever good college in Bombay. What's the name of the good college in Bombay? St. Navy. And Calcutta is St. Navy also. So if they are different class, they are league of their own, they will follow each other. If somebody attacks them, they will go on attack irrespective of their party affiliation. So you have to be very careful about what you are saying. TV shows are not done, for example, I am a little surprised. TV shows are done on only one college, because who is the college? Sensi one college. Who is the anchor? Sensi Kenyon. Who are the panelists? Sensi Kenyon. Who are the politicians? Sensi Kenyon. As if they run the country. So that gives bad name to journalism. If you look at a TV channel, you will find in their discussion table, you will find if you start counting, only 49 people in the country, they are on every channel every day. 49 people in the country. You'll find them 8 o'clock at one TV channel, 8:30 at second TV channel, 8:40 at third TV channel. Because I introduce them some days, OB-man is waiting outside my house. If you go to minister's house, you find 4 OB-men standing there, one after another interviewing them. Yesterday, Narendra Singh gave 12 interviews in the Kalanji Dr. Delhi. All the chief people are going to interview in the same room, same hour. So this is what we want. We want paki pakai roti ghar mein haja, hume banani nahi chahiye. So roti jo paki hui jayegi, it will be the same. So it will taste the same. Ingredient will be same. Cook will be same. Service will be same. Only thing is, who is better looking at the TV, the person who is serving you. That's the only difference. The media job is now to save yourself. Don't look at the color, don't look at the presentation, look at the content which they carry. Medium is more important. Message is more important. You have to weigh between the two. Now what is happening? Message is losing credibility. Medium becoming important. In the process, politicians are dividing each other. If you speak against one politician, he will not come on your channel. He will not give you interview because there are 20 other channels who are willing to do it. Modi has done one wonderful thing. He has been my friend for 40 years, but I have been his worst critic also recently. He does one very wonderful thing. He said, I will not meet journalists, I will not take journalists to abroad on my trip. He is the first prime minister after many years, for which I must congratulate him. Because there is a free ride to people like us who would go free in the plane. We put there on a hotel. But there is a competition, who will give the beautiful story supporting the Prime Minister. Manmohan Singh, I went with him twice, thrice in fact. Atalji, I went 5 times there. I went with Rajiv Gandhi twice. I covered almost 11 Prime Ministers. I called 10 of them. Devagoda never went abroad. Gujarat never went abroad. I went with 9 of them. So Modi is right thing, because why should we go be freeloaders on this trip? I have written a mail to him, I wrote it to VP Singh also, I wrote to Atal Bihari Vajpayee also, that you should ask for us to pay our passages, right? So we are asking for freebies. It means we are compromising. Let the proprietor pay for the news gathering. Why should somebody else pay? You should not go and hire the junkets. If you go, you must announce, I have got a free junket, I am writing it, because they took me there. But problem is, our readers should also become much more responsible. they should not blame the media for what appears wrong, if they're feeling wrong. We give bad news, we give good news, we give independent news, we give biased news. It is for you to judge. But don't question the motive of journalists, because generally there is some kind of a conspiracy in India, sorry, some kind of a conspiracy to destroy the credibility of only institution, which is media, which is independent. There is an attempt to destroy judiciary, which is equally independent. So don't fall in prey to that. Because journalists are the only people out of 130, there may be earlier there 1.1% bad, and there not maybe 2% bad. Support the media, complain to the editor. But media should not become subject of public ridicule. Because I can see a conspiracy. Politicians want media to be destroyed at all, so that anybody think they write, even if it's correct. Log kahenge nahi ye to bika hua hai, kisi aur ke kahne pe likh diya. So I'm just urging you, all of you, that media, Indian media is still independent. It has problems, but it needs support of the readers and viewers. If you support us, I think we will be still in check on the bureaucracy, on the executive, on the judiciary. If you also don't support it, you are entering into a phase where anarchy will be there. There will be no check on anybody. Therefore, we have to go into that kind of thing. Other thing which I am saying, national media which is becoming dominant. Indian politics are always dominated by national leaders who have no regional base. Look at how many prime ministers have come. They were never in the regional leadership. Nobody was, most of them were not chief minister. They never had a post in the chief minister. Regional media plays a very important role in molding opinion. Now what is happening through TV, even the regional TVs are now being influenced by national TV channels. What they are carrying, that become the lead story in regional papers also. Which is wrong. Now, first time Modi, I say, a regional leader who was never a national leader has become a national leader. There is a positive way of looking at it. So, regional media should not be dictated by national concerns, because all of us at the national level are guided by only people living in 30 square kilometers, Bhutan Delhi. We meet them, we talk them like them, we eat like them, we behave like them, and we try to dictate on our taste on the rest. You must maintain your own independence. Regional media is much more powerful in this country. It is growing faster. It has much more independent journalism than the national media. The time has come when Delhi will not decide what will happen in Punjab. It will be Manohar Parikar who will decide what policies Mr. Modi will follow about technology in Delhi. So you have to be proud of your own independence. Like regional parties were deciding earlier in terms of who will become the prime minister. Now regional leaders have decided that I will become the prime minister. Regional media still have a full faith in the regional media. Regional media takes up the independent stand. We will be forced to follow the regional media. I remember first story about Antule cement scam was broken by the regional newspaper, Indian National Solidarity Corporation. Even so, stories are being broken now. But English media, the English channels, they decide about the fate of the nation, and we all believe it. That is a dangerous step which we have to take care of. So my only thing, way forward is, the regional media must remain independent. People must go through all the newspaper and form an opinion. Don't blame the media for that. On our part, we should not be influenced by the extraneous consideration, and we should fight back with the owners. And what somebody is asking, the old age, what should be done? I agree with you. The independent journalist is being isolated now. He is being victimized. When he retires, he has no money at all. If he is independent, there are many independent babus who don't have a house. I know some of them. We should take care of that. But that should be taken by the fraternity itself. We should not ask the government to give us the house, give us pension, give us the insurance. No. We should have our internal mechanism where all of us contribute some kind of a fund, where the future can be taken care of. Journalists should take care of the journalists, otherwise this profession will be mortgaged to people who fund the schemes. We should not mortgage ourselves. We should become independent economically, politically, consciously, only then I think India can grow faster. The time has come, the pride of India has to be protected. New York Times can't tell me what I should do. I should tell New York Times, we are better than the best. Thank you very much.